Welcome back, guys. Welcome to a brand new day for the TCG Worlds 2018. If you're watching this on YouTube, don't forget to leave a like. It really helps out the channel. And if you're live here with me on Twitch, thank you so much for being here. Wow, there's apparently... The chat box should not... Okay. Chat box should not be activated. Okay. So, thank you guys so much for being here. We're now going to be taking a look at Turtonator, the cards that my face is covering up, the ones right here, are 4-max elixirs, okay, so that you know the full list, it's 4-max elixirs, and then Turtonator with Kiawe. It's a deck that has done consistently well, but just hasn't gotten to that winning a tournament phase yet. It reminds me of last season when Volcanion was touted as a good enough deck, but not good enough to win a tournament, until it ended up winning Oceania International by Pedro, who I think is watching here somewhere. So we have Ho, that's not Ho, we have Ho. GX 190 HP, we have Sacred Fire dealing 50 damage to one of our opponent's Pokemon, no matter where it is. And then we have Phoenix Burn. Phoenix Burn is the main attack of the deck, dealing 180 damage, and we can't attack next turn. But just the sheer amount of damage is more than enough. With a Choice Band, we get to 210, which is a magical number to hit those Zoroark GXs or Lycanrocs. 200 and 210 is a magical number. 230 with access to Steam Up from Volcanion EX is also a magical number to deal with Gardevoirs, but we're looking at the 200 and 210 range as the numbers to hit. Now, Eternal Flame GX is a GX attack, but we are definitely never going to use it. Like, there might be some obscure situation where you use Eternal Flame to get back two Volcanion EXs so that you can double Steam Up next turn, but it's so rare that I don't think that's the case. Is my voice soft, guys? Is the sound off once again? Should be good, right? Should be good. Maybe you just need to increase the volume level a little bit, Illusions. Please tell me, guys, on chat if my voice is too low, so I can raise it a little bit. And so, we also have Turtonator GX. Wait, how are we going to power up Ho? We are going to power up with Kiawe. Kiawe allows us to search for 4 fire energy in our deck, up to 4 fire energy in our deck. We attach them to one Pokemon and then shuffle our deck, and then our turn ends. But if you're going first, you really don't mind your turn ending after you use Kiawe. We have 2 Turtonator GX, 190 HP, Sheltrap dealing 20, and next turn, if Turtonator is attacked, you place 8 damage counters on your opponent's Pokemon, and then you have Bright Flame dealing 160 damage and discarding 2 fires. So almost as good as Ho. The discard can be good in situations where you're up against something like a Gardevoir, or a Lele wants to retaliate the hit. The lower damage is made up for with Choice Band and Steam Ups, so it's not that big a deal. And this GX attack, Nitro Tank, is actually really good for the late game when your resources are low. You get to put 5 fire energy back from your discard pile onto your Pokemon in any way you like. So you get to power up sometimes even 2 or 3 Pokemon simultaneously. Then we have the 2 Volcanion EXs. The water typing is decent along with the fire, but they are here mostly for Steam Up, as the damage output 130 is just not up to par when compared to the other attackers. But Steam Up allows every other fire Pokemon to deal 30 extra damage by discarding a fire energy from our hand. So there's a lot of synergy between all the fire type Pokemon and also the Kiawe supporter. For support, we have the Triple Lele, one Oranguru to have some sort of end defense, and then finally we have the Dawnwings Necrozma. Dawnwings Necrozma ability Invasion allows us to bypass those restrictions where Ho or Volcanion cannot attack the next turn by simply promoting the Dawnwings with a Flowstone and then retreating. Now, there is the issue that Dawnwings Necrozma is actually weak to Dark type, which means weakness to Zoroark, which is probably the worst weakness to have currently in the game. But its ability against any Zorak deck, or against any deck rather, even against Zorak decks, can sometimes, even if it means you're gonna lose two prizes, you get enough advantage out of it that its weakness ends up being irrelevant. We have 4 Kiawe for supporters, and then 4 Sycamore for Guzma for Cynthia. No ends, so we're relying on our aggressiveness to carry us through the games, and more so than any sort of disruption we could have on our opponent's hands. We have 4 Ultra Ball and 4 Max Elixir, of course, and then we have triple Trace Band, triple Floatstone, and then singles of Field Blower, Super Rod, and Nest Ball, along with 14 basic Fire Energy. So let's jump into the ladder and play a couple of games with this deck. Now let's see how it goes. And in the meantime, huge shout out to our sponsors, Tabletop Village, Soccer Scoop, and Ultimate Guard. Also, there's a special event happening in Mexico, in Cancun, on the 26th and 27th of May. It offers the same championship points as regionals, in case you're looking to close out your invite, or you're looking for that top 16 spot in North America, or even top 22 in Europe, or top 8 in Latin America. And it's going to be quite the event. It's also the weekend of my birthday. My birthday is 25th of May, so it should be a nice vacation to have for that date. And yeah, it's going to be quite the event, because I also believe, depending on the amount of people that show up, there will be some pretty good prizes. And all the info can be found on the website pokexop.com. Okay, so we seem to be up against a Glacian Garb deck. I do expect to see this deck at Charlotte Regionals, but I will say that I'm very lucky to already have the Kiawe here. And Kevin, I'm not running any Wofet this time around, just want to keep the deck as simple as possible, but the Wofet lists have also been decently successful. Energy onto Ho, and then Kiawe onto the benched Ho, I believe, is the right call here. The one big issue is the GX attack here, but my opponent did attach a Floatstone. That means he can't attach a Choice Band anymore, which is good. And a few of us, I definitely have not seen people running one energy and one Aqua Patch in bulk. I definitely have not seen that. Soli, thanks so much for the follow. Thank you so much for the follow. Okay. And Evolutions, why water energy with Max Elixir Kiawe? Yeah, I mean, I don't think, I've never seen that, honestly, but. Fiodabuzz, NA players need 400, but they have top 16 for day 2, not top 8. Europeans need less championship points to qualify for Worlds because they have less events. It's as simple as that, I believe. They have less events. Overall, they have less big events such as regionals, and I also believe they have less League Cups. So that's one of the reasons. And North America has a lot of regionals. In Latin America is where we need only 250 championship points, and we have top 8 for day 2. So you got a bit confused there. And okay, this Choice Band top deck is actually really, really good. I think I'm going to play down the Floatstone as well and touch the energy. So we get a knockout on the Glacian here. Really straightforward game here. Things are looking good. Things are looking good. Ooh, if I had been patient with the Floatstone, I would have had the Dawnwings Necrozma to just reset this hole, which would have been amazing. Oh, wow. I mean, there was a chance of N, so that's why I played it down. I did search my deck with Kiawe, but I didn't know that Dawnwings Necrozma was prized. And even if I did know, I would have never assumed I would get it. We see a multi-switch, that's fine. We're gonna see an energy drive. So dealing with this Lele is gonna be a bit annoying unless we hit this elixir, which we do. So it's gonna be as simple as we Kuzma knock out this Glacian with a Choice Banded hole. And then we have two holes, so no matter if this one goes down, this one cleans up the Lele. If this one goes down, this one cleans up the Lele, because my opponent would have used Kuzma. So very straightforward and clean game for the whole deck. Not even using less than 25, using less than half the deck. Not bad, not bad. Okay, there's an end. It literally doesn't matter here. Evolutions in South Africa, you only need 250 points. I believe there are events in South Africa. I mean, I assume you live in a different city where the events are held at. But as far as I remember, I do recall seeing like special events and stuff like that being held in South Africa. Okay, enough of the end, we get the Lele. So we get to Kuzma. And then we just went here. Yep, there it is. Okay. Okay, so let's just try one more game with this. Well, maybe one or two more. Yeah, for Latin America, it's also 250 championship points. So it's fairly easy to qualify if you get to go to events. And it seems like we're going to have a ton of special events from this point onwards. So with enough practice, we should have quite a few qualified players from Latin America. Now, if they actually go to Worlds or not, that's a different situation. But we should have quite a few people qualified at least. Okay, so no Ho-Oh for us to Kiawe onto. Yeah, it's nice when the deck works like this for sure. We don't know what we're up against. Okay, so we seem to be getting really lucky today. I'm just gonna Kiawe. I don't want to touch the energy because, and I don't want to have Ho up in the active spot. If I get my Flotsam Field Lord away, that's fine. But I keep the energy so that I can steam up and then I can use Sacred Fire to knock out Azorua rather than Phoenix Burn. Ah, okay, 600 to 1600 kilometers away. I priced 2 energy. Thank you, Firavos. I definitely didn't notice that. Okay. So we're up against a Lycanroc, a Zorak Lycanroc. There's a strong, as long as I don't bench too many more Pokemon, there's the Field Blower, so yeah, probably should have retreated. Okay, so I think I just Kuzma knock out this Rockruff. I Kuzma knock out this Rockruff with a Steam Up plus Phoenix Burn. I don't have a good follow-up to this though. That's the issue. Like, I'll go down to 3 prizes, but then I don't have a backup Ho like I did the previous game. Yeah, Sacred Fire here. Onto the active. Sorry, maybe I got the names confused. hello, JBAT. Thanks so much for being here. Team MCR. I know I played one of the members at London this year. Thank you so much for the follow as well. Okay, there's the N. That's fine. Just want a fire energy on your hand. There's an Evil Soda. I assume my opponent won't want to evolve the active. Yeah, I was gonna say. So if my opponent attaches an energy to Rockruff, we might try to take it down. If he doesn't, I actually think I'm gonna Ultra Ball into another Ho and Kiawe onto it. I think that would be a good play. Like, having two Ho's fully powered up sounds like the way to win this match. I believe that's how we will win this. Okay, there's an Ultra Ball. We could see a Lycanroc to just try to buy him time for my opponent, which seems fair. No, we see another Zoroark. Illusions, it's a custom built computer. I wanted to make sure I had a lot of like future proof, if you will. There's a DC. Okay. So that means we won't be able to do the Kiawe thing this turn. We get the Ho at least, which is good. Okay, we do hit an Elixir. And now we need either... Is it worth it to Ultra Ball for Oranguru? I think it is. Losing the Kuzma is not a big deal, I don't think. The Oranguru is actually... Okay, so in an ideal world, we get either two fire or a fire and a choice band. I'm gonna instruct because it's unlikely that after the Cynthia... Okay, perfect. Well, not perfect. I really want to attach the energy, but I think I need to steam up to secure... Like, that guarantees a knockout. If I get another energy here, then awesome. There's a choice band. Okay, so I got them the other way around than I wanted to. Got them the other way around. So that's fine. There's even a chance the Ho survives, honestly. There's even a chance the Ho survives. Yeah, I did a lot of research, and custom build seems to be best and cheapest indeed. And I wanted to have like a lot of powerful hardware to make sure that this computer lasts me for a few years, so that the big investment I did from my savings is worth it. And yeah, and a huge shout out to the people from Parallel. Okay, goodbye. Huge shout out to the people at the GoFundMe who donated. It's still up. Like, I went ahead and got the computer, but it's still up in case people still want to chip in at gofundme.com/tableman. Yeah, okay, so lots of trading. No signs of energy for my opponent. He needs a basic and a DCE to knock out this Ho. If he does that, we're in a lot of trouble. There's a DCE or a choice band as well. That works. Did he whiff? No. He probably has a Lele. Or he has a Mew and he's iffy on benching it. If he doesn't have a basic, that's so sad though. Yeah, there's a stretcher. Okay. Okay. So this is where we are in a bit of trouble. I might have to take a turn to Kiawe here. Onto the Ho, and the issue is my opponent could just have Kuzma and get the first hit in on the Ho. And I believe that's what's going to happen. If I had the Kiawe here and I could bench the other Ho, that would be ideal. I don't think I can do that. I'm gonna have to Lele for the Kiawe, which is not ideal. Okay. Yeah, but without Kiawe, I literally don't have any sort of threat. I'm also gonna Ultra Ball to Finn. I fully expect an end here. Churchinator could potentially be good. The Field Blower would be really nice. And do I expect an end? Probably. So I'll play the Choice Band down. One Field Blower down out of probably two? Okay. So there's no way my opponent doesn't have... Wait, why did he get back a Rockruff instead of a Zorua? That makes no sense. There's no way my opponent doesn't have a Kuzma here, right? No way. Hello, Julian. Thank you so much for being here. Yeah, a Kuzma or a Lycanroc. That works. That definitely works. So yeah, first hitting on the hole. I'm actually not that scared of the Lycanroc. What I need is to power up this Volk and to Guzma knock out one of the Rockruffs. That's the goal here. Rockruff is gonna be my last prize, probably, hopefully. I've only played one Elixir, which is good news. Yeah, I just take down this Zorak. Yeah, the float to Lycanroc is actually really bad for that boss, as you say. Well, I wasn't planning on playing another bench Pokemon, though. Okay, the Mewtwo is also a guarantee that we win, because Rockruffs could have potentially evolved into Lycanrocs, which were out of range to get knocked out by Volcanion EX. But Mewtwo always has 130 HP, so we should always be able to knock out that Mewtwo. Okay, so we don't get energy, which is fine. We kept the choice band. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put back 3 fire energy. That means there's 5 energy for my elixirs. Now there's 4. So the odds of me hitting the elixirs are actually worse. But I did. Okay. So we take 2 prizes here. Then my opponent ends us down to 1 card. So it's gonna come down to Guzma. Getting the Ultra Ult back is really good. Getting the Ultra Ult back is really good. And having more fire energy does open up the possibility of attaching Choice Band, benching another Volk EX, and then using double Steam Up for knockout on the Lycanroc. So, I mean, it's gonna come down to what cards we have in our hand. But Volk EX might actually be able to take a hit, which is good. Because we definitely weren't planning on having 3 bench Pokemon. Maximum 2, unless we have a chance to get a knockout on the Volk EX. There's the trade. Evan really needs to end. He still has double puzzles, right? And has only played 2 end out of at least 3, maybe 4. And he also has only 1 puzzle. Okay, so he's gonna choose to take the knockout with Zorak. If he doesn't end, we win, because we just Guzma. If he doesn't end, that's a really bad play by my opponent. He really, really needs to end. Julian, thank you so much for subscribing. That's so kind of you. Thank you for choosing to use your Twitch Prime subscription with me. Thank you so, so much. That's very kind of you. Very, very kind of you. Okay, there's a Cynthia, so we just won the game. Cynthia means we just won the match. Thank you, Julian. Thank you so much for subscribing. That's very kind of you. And yeah. Zorak knocks out, and then Volk knocks out my opponent with the Guzma that we have in our hand. Even if I made the mistake of promoting the Volk, we have energy to retreat the Lele. So yeah, just gonna go after the Mewtwo, which has 130 HP, and coincidentally, we deal 130 damage. Perfect. Okay, so we probably have time for one more game before I have to get going to prepare the coaching lesson. So, 4 win streak, 2 with Rampardos, 2 with Ho Turtonator. So far we are 4-for-5 with this deck. This is where I wish I was using my regular account. Get this one to grind through a ladder, because this new ladder is really cool, right? With the full art N and the computer search. Okay, so we get to go first, which is awesome. And yes, Julian, I am going to Toronto Regionals for sure. Yeah, the parallel the opposite way would have definitely helped my opponent. I did wink at something off screen. Something or someone. My girlfriend. And now she's blushing. Okay. We're up either against Guardi or Zorak Guardi. Team Squid. What is Team Squid? Okay. So this is... Seeing a Lele up front is actually the worst thing here. And having all these four, all four energy, that's 4, 8, 12, so we have 2 energy prize once again. Having all this energy and nothing on the bench to attach to is sad. So we're hoping my opponent doesn't have a DCE here. We're hoping my opponent, Swagginator 5000, doesn't have a DCE. Best team ever. Is Team Squid something to do with what's this, the name of this game? Splatoon? Is Team Squid something to do with Splatoon? Okay. There's a Bridget, the Brigetti Spaghetti, and it is Zorg, Guardi. Oh, everyone did have the DCE. No! How do you start Bridget Lele when coincidentally we're up against Foe? Manchas, thank you so much for the cheer. That's very kind of you. Okay. So I think I just Cynthia here. I'm gonna attach this to Thin. We need another basic. Or, I mean, what does my opponent have in his 2-card hand? That was really lucky. Octillery. Ah, okay, okay. Ah. It was so sad. I mean, my opponent's start was okay, but... He started double Lele against us. He also had the DD and the Choice Man. I don't think he needed to attach the Choice Man, though. I think you'd rather save that for the routes. Okay, so my opponent immediately promotes a Lele, assuming he's gonna get another TCE. If he doesn't, we are actually in a pretty good position. But he does, so never mind. So never mind. Oh boy. I'm going to Charlotte. I fly out tomorrow. Ugh, come on. Perfect starting hand, perfect Cynthia for 6. Well, not perfect, I guess. He was missing the rare candy card. Okay. So, if I Ultra Ball... Okay. This is really sad, but I think I have to do this. Sycamore and Kuzma? No. Cynthia and Kuzma. So I'm gonna play everything. Okay, so we're gonna get the Dawn Wings, which... Oh, Dawn Wings is prized. Come on. What is this? What? Dawn Wings is prized. Oh, gosh. Dawn Wings is right. Okay, so we need to hit 2 more elixirs and a floatstone. Easy, right? Ugh. Okay, so I guess we just need to be patient here. This loses a lot of tempo. A lot of tempo. At least we can get rid of the Ralts potential next turn. And then we follow that up with a knockout on the Zorak. Now there's 2 Ralts to deal with. Mallow for the rare candy to Guardi. My opponent just not whiffing. Fiona Buzz. I know, I was being sarcastic of me. I was being sarcastic. Okay. There's a trade. Oh, so bad. Yeah, a Guardi just completely ruins our day. There it is. And then energy drive two cards in my hand, in my opponent's hand. Okay, there's the floatstone. So we could still get it. Then Gardy just wrecks my hole. Now we just need one elixir. Which doesn't seem unreasonable. Or I could Ultra Ball for Turtonator and use the GX attack. I feel like that's the way to go about it. Okay. And I want to keep one fire energy. Okay, we have a plan here, guys. We have a plan. Okay. Wolf it would have been amazing indeed. Okay. So 5 fire energy exactly, 3 and 2. Actually think we do it. Okay, we're gonna attach all 5 of course, but we're just gonna, no, we need 2 here. There's no way off of 2 cards my opponent has Kuzma Fairy, right? Kuzma Fairy DC, he needs to knock out this hole. That would be insane. Now we have the exact cards to knock out Gardevoir here. Okay, so no draw support, yes, but I need, like, my plan here is to knock out the Gardevoir. If I don't knock out the Gardevoir, I lose. Oh my gosh. Double puzzle into the Fairy and the DC. And the Guzma, what? He had 2 cards in hand. My plan was for my opponent to not get the absolute nuts every turn, and for me to be able to get rid of the Guardian next turn. That's why I got rid of the Lele. That was ridiculous. Every turn has been just insane. Every turn has been insane for my opponent. Fair enough, Tiramisu Lover. Like, Zoroark allows for that, but it's not like my opponent's deck is 10 cards. And it's not like he has a 6 or 7 card hand. If he has that, then yeah, sure. But in this case, he had 2 cards. He had 2 cards, which became 3, then he drew 4 more, he had 7 cards. And coincidentally, he also had the DC and the Fairy in the discard piles. Like, but it was also the Lele start, the DC on turn 1, the DC off of the Cynthia on turn 2 with 3 cards, with 3 left in the deck, and a 30 card deck. Like, every little thing. The 2 cards were double puzzle. Oh, there you go. That works, Agnator. Yeah, I mean, it happens, right? It happens. Yeah, I mean, any deck that has Guardy is gonna be a bad matchup for Ho-Oh Turtonator. Every time, like, Ho-Oh Turtonator became viable because Guardy took a huge swing. Guardy took a huge swing down in popularity. But now that it's not as popular, that's why the deck is viable again. So Zoroark Guardy is probably its worst nightmares. It's okay, Swagginator. GG, thank you for explaining. Yeah, I guess if you already had the double puzzle, then you just needed the Guzma, which was actually fairly easy to get with Lele's Ultra Balls and still 1 or 2 left. You stop playing Metagross, Fyodabuzz, because it's really bad with Zoroark. Okay guys, so thank you guys so much for watching and for hanging out. I have to go now because I have coaching to do from now until the next 6 hours, I believe. So it's gonna be a long day. But thank you guys so much for hanging out. If you're watching on YouTube, don't forget to leave a like. Swagginator, GG for that last game. And yeah, I will see you guys. I will see some of you guys in Charlotte. Hopefully, I get to do well. I get to be on stream. I'll let you guys know on Facebook and Twitter and whatnot. And I will see you guys definitely next week for more high-level streaming that we currently have with the new computer. So yeah, thank you guys so much for being here. Thank you for everything. And hopefully next week we will be able to feature Lucario GX on the channel. Okay, so thank you guys and bye-bye.